During Sunday night, we lost one of the transmission towers that evacuates power from Owen Falls to Lugogo in Kampala. What this means is we have lost half of the capacity from Owen Falls, which is between 80 to 95 megawatts of power of non-supply. What this has meant is that our customers consuming up to 80 megawatts of power are currently undergoing load shedding at the moment to allow for restoration of this line. Just to assess the impact, we've, as Umeme, been forced to switch off our customers using the Namugongo substation, Waligo substation. We've switched off Kakiri substation. We've switched off the whole of the Bombo industrial load area to ensure that we can accommodate the 80 megawatts of power. And until such a time when this tower is restored, we will continue to rotationally switch off our customers at least once in 3 days to enable the load sharing of the existing loads that are being generated and transmitted to Kampala. Our general appeal again, as the minister emphasized on Thursday, is to watch out and ensure the public desist from vandalizing electrical infrastructure, because the cost is much higher. Cost of non-supply of electricity, the cost of the equipment, each tower here costs more than $100,000 to be restored, and the general safety of the public. You can imagine all these wires that are lying down. We appeal again, once again, to the government, the security forces, and other investigative agencies to put in mechanisms in place to ensure that culprits, wherever they are found, whether it's the market for the equipment that they steal from the network, or whether it's being used to sabotage, the culprits and the intention should be identified and dealt with. For me, it's a sad day at the moment where the bulk of our customers are not being supplied because of individuals' selfish interests of stealing metal parts and bringing the network down. This is very significant, and we are on the back of 2 weeks ago, again in Western Uganda, one tower was vandalized near Nkenda substation, and there was intermittent supply in the areas of Kasese, Fort Potro, and Hoima. At least in that area, we had an alternative in feeding customers from Rugonjo and the Kabula Soke line. But unfortunately for this line, we do not have an alternative at the moment, and we shall continue load shedding until such a time when transmission company restores this supply.